Normally, any criticism of Israel is immediately dismissed as anti-Semitism. However, this is one incident that they will not be able to hide behind. An Israeli organ trafficker who has been trafficking organs for a number of years has finally been arrested in Cyprus. Police in Cyprus have arrested an Israeli man described as the ringleader of a worldwide organ trafficking network that operated out of the tiny Balkan country of Kosovo several years ago. Moshe Harel is accused of taking people from Eastern Europe, Turkey, and the former Soviet Union, and Kosovo, promising to pay them 12,000 euros for a kidney. He then allegedly charged people, who are mostly Israeli, who needed a kidney, of as much as 100,000 euros for the organ. Both Kosovo and Russia have issued warrants for Harel's arrest. Kosovo has requested his extradition. It is not clear if Russia has done likewise. Based on an international arrest warrant for the suspect, M.H. was arrested a few days ago in Cyprus. He has been a wanted person since 2010. Israeli police arrested Harel in 2012 in a related investigation, but he was never extradited to Kosovo because the two countries don't have diplomatic relations. Now, the trafficking ring has since then been shut down. It operated out of a Medicus clinic, which is on a residential road outside the outskirts of Pristina in the capital of Kosovo. Now, the scandal came to light in 2008 when a Turkish man collapsed in an airport after having a kidney removed. And then, you know, when he collapsed, paramedics got to him, noticed that he had had an organ missing, and that's what spurred the investigation that eventually led to this arrest. The clinic was run by a urologist, Lufti Dervishi. He was convicted of participating in organized crime and organ trafficking and was sentenced to 8 years in prison. His son, Arben, was convicted of the same charges in 2013 and sentenced to 7 years in prison. Both men went into hiding. Now, altogether, there were five Kosovolian doctors who were sentenced up to 8 years in prison each for the organ trafficking. The donors whose organs were obtained illegally were left without proper medical care and treated like waste, according to the prosecutors at the time of the trial. Now, there's two very blatant things here. One, this is straight up capitalism. This is straight up the profit motive over human life. These people are vultures who took advantage of the most disadvantaged people in the continent, in the poorest countries, and then completely screwed them. I mean, 12,000 euros for an organ that was sold for 100,000, that's a hell of a racket to get into. I couldn't think of a better definition of exploitation than this right here. And the second thing is something that a lot of people don't want to talk about, and that is the very ideology of Israel itself, the Zionism, in that its adamant belief that other people are less than human and don't deserve the same rights as other people. No, you only really have to look as far as the way they treat Palestinians. I mean, this extends to other people too, and one of the great hypocrisies of Western Christians that support Israel, in full knowledge that Israel considers them to be less than human. They're not part of God's chosen people. This kind of religious-based chauvinism over other peoples, and it's very much right there. True, this guy has finally gone to jail, but it seems the Israeli authorities weren't really all that interested in looking into it when they had originally arrested him many years earlier.
Thank you for watching. If you like this program, then please head over to my Patreon page and set up a monthly donation. It's your donations that keep this program running. Also, if you would like, please rate, comment, subscribe, and share in various social media.